Hey everyone, how's it going? So I know I haven't done a video in a while, and the hawk haters out there probably don't like that. So today I'm gonna do a video on the hawk. I have so many things going on, so many things are like broken, and quite honestly, I'm pretty burned out. I've already taken the top bolts out, 13 millimeter here. Let's see if it's 13 millimeter on there. Yep. So the nut on the other side is 14 millimeter. There we go. Alrighty, so there we go. The shock is on its lowest setting, and as you turn it up these notches, it will put more and more pressure on this spring. So, if I was strong enough, I could just squeeze it and turn it. I do have a hook wrench. I just don't know where it is. So I'm probably gonna do the really nasty thing and grab a pipe wrench and turn this over. It's one click. Two clicks. That wasn't that bad. I'm gonna be completely honest. It's been a long time since I used the pipe wrench to do that. And it's a little boogered up there. Took me a minute to figure out how this was done. So, if you ever need to or whatever, you really don't need a hook wrench, but you do need to remember the technique. You need to get in between the teeth with the wrench, and you know, it's really thin, it'll slip out pretty easy. But give it a turn, there it is. Beautiful. So, I got, what is it? Two more clicks I could go, but we'll see if this will be stiff enough for the suspension to not bottom out. Hopefully it will be. So I'm gonna put this, it's a lot of work, but you know, I might have to do this one more time. Another thing I wanted to mention, I know a couple people have asked, how well does this shock hold up? Well, as you can see, or maybe you can't see, there's been like almost no mileage on this, and this bushing is already a bit loose. And I'm sorry, trying to get it up to the camera. You can see it's quite compressed. Alrighty, so there's my cold start, and as you can see, she started right on the first kick. And for some reason today, she doesn't even really want the choke on. But keeping it real, she stalled out right as I was gonna get going, so. Yeah, she still has that cough, and I'm not sure what that is, and I'm starting to think that maybe I can bump up another size or two in the jets. I think I'll have to look at my notes, I'll have to look at my other videos, but I think I have a 110 jet in here, and that's the only like real modification to speed other than the front sprocket. I mean, it's still a 1750 setup, and yeah, I'll stop rambling on and let's go for a ride. Alrighty, so I'm back from my ride, and I don't know how much of that I'll put in the video, but I had a really hard time starting to hawk up after I got gas, and my fault for wearing, you know, those kinds of shoes. I should have put some boots on, since I don't, since I'm always kickstarting it. But anyway, she finally started, but other than that, she's running really, really good, and I got some top speed runs in there for a little bit. Not as high as I would like to have seen. I still need to take that head off and address that mild oil leak. I really don't think that's going to affect my top speed, because I'm pretty sure I know what that is, and I don't think it's an actual head leak. But the shock is all the way adjusted now, and it did add a little bit of clearance, but a little more ground clearance, and my feet are a little more off the ground, but it's perfectly comfortable. And riding this thing, I don't know, the suspension on it, I absolutely love it. It's way too squishy. It's kind of bouncy, but it's really nice and soft, and I can't wait to start jumping it and start actually going for rides with it. And hopefully that'll happen this year. I'm not going to make any promises, but one of my goals is to get a trailer and start, you know, taking this thing out on some adventures and you know, using it the way it was meant to be used. So I think that's going to do it for now. And yeah, coming up, I'm going to be doing a comparison with this little scooter. I'm going to leave with that. I'm going to stop rambling. So thanks for watching. And until next time, I'll catch you guys later. Have a good one.